This is Artifacts of Mars. And the UN is eyeing taking over the world's oceans. You don't want this. Believe me. The United Nations has launched a far-reaching initiative that could give UN-sponsored authorities sway over biological resources of the high seas, all of ours that lie outside national territories and economic zones. Yeah, right, like they're going to stop there. Potential shift in power involves multi-trillion dollar issues, such as whether large areas, conceivably as much as 30% of the world's international waters, should be designated as no-go areas to protect biological diversity, whether and how to elaborate environmental impact assessments for future ocean development projects, and how to divide up the economic benefits from future development of marine genetic resources. That's gobbledygook for saying they want to take away the country's sovereignty. You don't want this, believe me.
That is bullshit.
Eden Charles, a diplomat from Trinidad and Tobago, who's serving as chairman for UN Preparatory Committee that began discussions this week, underlined to Fox News that talks are at a very, very preliminary stage. Which means that is a lie. That means they're getting ready to take over.
You are a liar. Liar, liar, pants on fire.
Overall, the hoped-for treaty will cover two-thirds of the oceans, almost half of the planet, says Lisa Spear, senior official of the National Resources Defense Council, which is in turn a member of a squadron of 33 environmental groups banded together on the High Seas Alliance to lobby for protectionist measures during the talks. This means your country is going to get screwed on a trade rights and so forth. The rationale behind the discussions, easing the rising pressure on the world's oceans, undersea biodiversity wrought by overfishing, pollution, drainage of nutrients and other substances from surrounding lands, disturbance of underwater seabeds, and fears of even greater threats from underwater industrial technology, including underwater exploration for hydrocarbons. Translation? We're not going to let them drill for oil anymore. Let's take a look at the treaty. Hang on. Right here's the treaty. You let the UN get a hold of the world's oceans, and you may as well get used to herding goats and sheep and living like your ancestors a few centuries ago lived, because they'll reduce the world to nothing more than a big feudal state where the elites live great and you're living in a grass hut. There's a treaty called the Law of the Sea Treaty, and I never really understood it, but that's bad news as well. And it mentions this, decides to develop an international legally binding instrument under United Nations Convention on Law of the Sea on the conservation and sustainable use of marine biological diversity of areas beyond national jurisdiction to that end. So they're going to bring the Law of the Sea Treaty into this. And it just goes on and on. Look, the whole point of this is to stifle trade. We all know that most of our trade occurs by the sea. Trade between nations. That's been since the beginning of time. Now, if the UN gets a hold of this, you are screwed. Like I said, these global communists like the UN, basically they want you to live in grass huts and herd goats so they can control you. Okay, I may be exaggerating some, but not much. This is bad news all the way around. You might want to call up your legislator and say, no way, tell the UN to go climb a tree. Tell them to get lost. The UN is an organization that's made up of thugs and dictators anyway. You want them in control of your oceans? Nothing good can come of this. I guarantee you. I'm Artifactsofmars. Thanks for watching.